Welcome to Jake and Wright's brainstorming video for a birdhouse. My team members are Dr. John Bunch, Heather Payne, Rhonda Rogers, and Ty.
Tennessee, I think rains are very common.
Rains are common.
So, you know, we have a good chance of attracting them. Because they're putting them around.
They're everywhere. In Walmart parking lot. Eating french fries.
Alright, so it looks like we have the type of bird, so we can go back to the size.
Well, they're little.
It's a well good little one.
Yes.
And it's common, it's heavy. It's easy to attract them because they're everywhere in this part of the country. So you wouldn't have to invest too much work into attracting them.
What do they keep? That'll kind of help us determine how to innovatively put it into their small bird house, because it's going to need to be fairly small because they like to be tucked away in the little nooks and crannies, right? Mm-hmm. So, what do they eat?
Well, the one thing I saw when they eat cheddar cheese.
So little
scraping the cheddar cheese and small little tidbits might be tasty for them.
Right.
And make them select our birdhouse
over
competitive birdhouse.
Right. Birds are nice.
I know.
Not for mice. Yeah.
They like Swiss cheese, right?
Yes.
Do they eat any kind of seed?
I think they do.
Small seed.
Maybe even some mealworms.
Mealworms.
I think they like mealworms also.
Suet?
Exactly.
That can be butter, right?
Yep. You have peanut butter with peanuts and you can put cheese in it too. You know, you can. They make all kinds of suet. So then we probably want to put some sort of food source in or around the bird to make it more fun.
So where would you put it?
Where would you put it?
Yes, I'm going to put it.
Or keep it on the bottom of the house or keep it out of the weather?
Mm-hmm.
On the pole?
Yeah, maybe if I could.
Like a squirrel
proof it.
Yeah, we've got to keep one of the worms away from the squirrels.
Right.
We can call those little blocks.
Now, a lot of times, you put like a little wire cage and then slide a little suet down the end of the peck for the cage.
Especially with little birds.
Yeah. Yeah,
because
they can get it.
Yeah. Does this person have trees? Do they have a fence?
Do they have an open spot or a pole to dance in? I think though, if you put it on the pole, most squirrels work. It's going to really keep down.
But you're also going to have it at a reasonable level to where you can change your food.
Or the pole can be telescoping so that you can pull it down when you need to.
So, ponies have issues for too long because cats
are going
to jump up to try to get the birds because I've seen this in action in our own yard.
You say too low?
Too low, yes. So you have to find a happy medium where you can keep it away from cats. But also make it friendly enough to people so they can get it up.
Yeah, happy hike.
A happy bird.
A happy bird.
Like that?
Yes.
A happy bird.
Yeah. Okay. Cats also will walk across the top of the fence to get to the top of the bird house. So you have to be careful when you attach them to a fence because it gives them a little walkway to walk up to it and they'll just reach their little paw down there and pop it because it's in that action.
You have many dogs.
I also have neighbor cats that come over and I'll look.
Tom, yeah, you can. Yeah. Okay.
So I like pole probably better because it just seems to not have as many issues as putting it on a fence.
Okay. Yeah, I can. And it's on a friend, have it on a pole.
What was the food source? Small food, the mixture is going to have some sunflower seeds in it, but it will be other nuts. So we have the bird, we've got how it's going to the source and hold it. We're gonna put it in, then I'm gonna think it's safe. Yes, safe for us.
So, there you put in folks on the, you know, the size, you know, the bird, you know, the size, the location, food for protection.
So, so, well, back to the original question, is this a duplex or is this like a single, and I asked you to turn, got a rent, so now what was a rent made?
So they're social.
Rents are very social, very important.
I think they would, yeah, they would like a multi. Yes.
Minimum of duplex, I think, or a lonely bird there.
Right.
Or the exact.
We want to have it.
Yeah.
So, duplex.
I think the size of the whole birdhouse might be exclusive to keep the larger.
Larger birds out.
Hawking birds and stuff like that, and really things out.
That's about that, but there are some scavengers that come in and take over birds.
So do you agree on the pole?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to get the
squirrel. Five feet or?
Squirrel.
Yeah, the little comments on there.
Okay, so we can also put the trolls in yellow and the pole and the squirrels in the pond.
Yeah.
It's a great idea, right?
Yeah, it's up to us.
Pet jelly? Charlie jelly?
Okay, so what else do you want to do? The slinky.
Yep.
Okay, you can put the slinky on the, you put the pole down through the slinky, and then when they start climbing up the slinky goes.
That's pretty cool.
So if we put the jelly on the pole and we put the slinky around it, there's no way.
It's totally safe, yeah.
Yeah, those guys would get that up.
What type of wood should we choose? Because, you know, there are a lot of different insects or pests around that may infest it, but I think some of the wood choices might help on that.
Well, you know, cedar seems like a really good choice, but I think it's actually not.
Oh, okay.
Sometimes the aromatic wood is a deterrent to some birds.
Correct.
Yeah,
it repels bugs, like pine.
I need a pine is
good. Pine is easy to work with, pine is expensive.
It is expensive.
Drop the turn of pounds into holes on the
ground. But it's also, if it's on the pole, it's also got to be balanced.
That's it.
It looks cozy.
And that's our rainstorm for the cozy.